Dear scholars, through the previous video, we have put an end to learning the lesson, the past in the present. Let us see the activities given in English workshop based on this lesson. So here we go with first. In the diagram below, encircle the various features that make the script of a skit or play. List the other words and mention the form of writing of which it is a feature. First, sender's address. What do you think? To what writing skill it belongs? So it is letter writing, right? So it belongs to letter writings. Next, salutation. It also belongs to letter writing. Next one, live dialogue. Belongs to skit or play. So let us encircle these two words. Next, list of characters. It also belongs to skit. Lead line. It belongs to news report. Next one, diagram. It belongs to non-verbal information or non-verbal communication. Next, scene, stage scene and props. It belongs to skit. And last one, actions or costumes specified. It also belongs to skit or play. Second activity. Choose the proper alternative to complete the following. It is of fill in the blanks. First, let me give you one example. The skit covers a period of about ... in the past. In the past, how many years about the past mentioned in the skit or the play? 3000, 1000, 5000 or 1800? What is the answer? It is option C, 5000 years. The same way, you have to go with each, reading carefully the given sentences and options, fill in the blanks with correct answers, alternatives. Third activity, fill in the table. What table it is? The first column is of period. What period? 1950s, 1910, 1800 and so on. Way of addressing mother. What words they use to address the children from, or the boys from this period used to address their mother. Next, boy's costume, lady's costume, daily chorus of the boy and games they used to play. Let me give an example. First, 1950. Way of addressing mother. How the boy from 1950 addresses his mother. So what is it? By saying mama, right? Boy's costume from 1950. So it is loose trouser and shirt. Next, ladies costume, that is already given, silk sari. Daily chores of the boy. So what is it? That is watering garden, bringing groceries, dusting living room, etc. Right? Games. No game is mentioned in the skit which was used to be played by the boy from 1950. The same way, you have to write this information for 1910 boy, 1800 boy, 1500, 1000. 100 AD, that is Anno Domini, and 3000 BC, that is before Christian era. Fourth one, answer in your own words. First, what excuses did Neil give to avoid cleaning his room? So what excuses he made, what reasons he told that he wanted to go to play, he had already cleaned up the room 2 days before, there is no need to clean it every day, right? So this is all about the answer of the question A. The same way you have to write the answer of each sub question given in it. So read each question carefully and find their answers in the dialogues given in the skit. Next, fifth activity. In the play, two devices that make use of wheels are given. So what are those two devices which has wheels? It's simple question, but for the same purpose you need to read the lesson again, or if you know already you can write easily. Next, from the internet or other sources, trace the history of the use of wheel. Write an autobiography of a wheel. Autobiography of a wheel. So when you will write autobiography, it would be just like writing a story or an sorry it would be like writing an essay or a story. So while writing, you have to consider the wheel yourself. So whenever you will tell about wheel, at that time you have to use, or you have to start the sentence with the subject I. So what is it? First you write about origin of the wheel. For example, I was originated in the year, whatever it may be, or by whom, etc. You can write. Next, its uses, its importance, and how the life of man is depending on wheel today. That you have to write as an autobiography of a wheel. Next, sixth activity. Imagine that the ancestors from 1910 AD, that is Anno Domini, visits Neil in his dream. Compose a dialogue between the two about the various gadgets the visitor sees in Neil's room. So what do you think? If Neil's grandpa or his ancestor from 1910 comes in his dream, what he will observe? That various device gadgets, headphones, later on different play games, besides some other things, maybe computer or laptop, etc. So these all devices might be over there. So what conversation, what communication both of them will have? So definitely his ancestor from 1910 will ask him to put all the things in their proper places, and as the boy Neil mentioned as arrogant, how will he reply? Whether he will do that work or not, that you have to think, and accordingly the dialogue of Neil and his ancestor you have to write. Seventh activity. Imagine and compare an argumentative dialogue between the mothers of 20th or 21st century and those of the earlier era, about which life was better for women. So as women have different works to do, so whose life is better? That is from a life of a woman from modern age, that is 20th or 21st century, and the woman from earlier era. So you can take the names. As for modern woman, you can take today's name, and for earlier you can use names like Shakuntala, etc. So what dialogues they both of them will have in their discussion about the life which is better, that you have to write. Next, read the entry about voice, that is active voice and passive voice, in the language study pages. Note that the speeches of all the boys are in active voice. Turn them into passive constructions. Here is the example given. It is the dialogue of Neil. What is it? I put the dishes in the dishwasher. Right? So what you put in the dishwasher, that is the dishes, right? It is, you can consider the object, the dishes. Subject, verb, that is put, then dish, the dishes, object, and in the dishwasher, it is prepositional phrase, or you can consider an adverbial. So as you all know, when we start writing the answer of passive voice, we start with object first, right? So answer is already given here. What is it? Dishes have been put in the dishwasher. By whom? That is by me. So here the subject I is not converted into me, because it is understood. The same way here below the dialogues given, and those you have to convert or change into passive voice, and there is no need to write by me in all of these. So let us see the first one given over here. I have watered the garden. What is the object? The garden, right? So what will be the answer in passive? The garden has been watered. There is no need to write by me. Next one, brought home the groceries. So actually it is the sentence, I brought home the groceries. So it is the verb, brought verb, the groceries object. So your answer will start with the groceries, and as the word I doesn't get changed, or no need to write in the form of me, it is not given here. So easily you can do this, right? Let us see next activity. Think of suitable names for the boys from earlier centuries. What type of name they would have in earlier centuries? You can say the guru, etc., like this. So think of such names. Here again in the lesson, that Sampad Bhau, and other one more name is given. So you just think of some other name that is used in earlier centuries as the names of boys. 10th, form groups of 5 to 8, translate the play into your mother tongue or Hindi as a group activity. Enact the translation in the classroom. So it is not possible to enact in the classroom now. You just write in your notebook the same play you have to write in your mother tongue or Hindi. It may be Marathi, Hindi, or any other tongue, mother tongue, that you have to use to write this play in your notebook. Last activity, read what? The story of the amulet, which is written by E. Nesbitt. So this is all about all the activities given in English workshop of the lesson The Past in the Present. I hope you all will understand this given explanation, and accordingly you all will do all these activities easily.